Hey guys, welcome to the vlog. This is the channel where we talk about mostly sneakers and tech. And today we're going to do a very nice review of one of the most underrated shoes ever made, I think. It's the Under Armour Hover Sonic. If you guys haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please make sure that you do so. We are giving away a brand new Adidas Profeer the moment we hit 10,000 subscribers. First off, let me just apologize for the hair and the sweaty look. I actually just came from the gym, had a quick late night workout, and I was wearing, of course, the shoe that I'm going to feature today. This is the Under Armour Hover Sonic. This is, of course, the more affordable hover shoe that Under Armour came out with. The more what do you call this, expensive one, or the more premium one, is called the Under Armour Phantom. This is the step lower, the Sonic, which sells for a little over 6,000 pesos here in the Philippines. Now, I'll go right straight into it. This is probably the best shoe that Under Armour has ever released. And it is way up there, and it is a strong contender to the Ultra Boost of Adidas and the Nike Epic React Flyknit of Nike. Just for context, I actually started most of my sneaker collection with Under Armour, not Adidas, not Nike. And I have a few Under Armour pairs. This is the black, I even forgot what it's called. I'm not sure if this is like the Gemini model. This is one of my first Under Armour shoes. This is the second one. It's all covered in cat fur, but this one I don't like because the heel guard here at the back really hurts my foot. It hits the ankle pretty bad. So this one, not too much. And of course, being the Rock fan that I am, I picked up the Project Rock Delta trainers, which I love to train in and I just love to walk in. The only thing I hate about it is that giant Under Armour logo that they have here, which is actually also present in the other Under Armour shoes. For some reason, Under Armour just wants to plaster their giant logo all over their shoes, which is annoying because it really destroys the aesthetic of the shoe. If they kept this just like a plain black boot with the Rock logo, that would be so much more kick-ass. Anyway, which leads me to the Under Armour Hover Sonic. First things first, the look. They made it much better. How? By making the Under Armour logo small. And I can't stress that enough, because as you guys saw with the previous shoes that I just showed, the Under Armour logo was dominant in the design aesthetic, which pretty much just screamed it was an Under Armour shoe. This time it's a little more subtle, a little more toned down, and I think it's a good step for Under Armour when it comes to the overall design and style of their shoe. Next, let's talk about the comfort, and this is where I think it really shines. The Under Armour Hover Sonic is really in the middle of the Nike Epic React Flyknit, which is more on the bounciness side more than the comfort, and the Adidas Ultra Boost, which is more for the comfort than it is the performance. This is the one that's in the middle. And when I say that it's in the middle, it's the right amount of comfort and the right amount of energy response and bounce back and rebound, which really just wants you to keep on moving forward when you're running, when you're walking, when you're going for brisk walking, or when you're on the treadmill. It just keeps on pushing you forward. The magic actually is all in the midsole. Now, inside this white thing, is actually an EVA case, which is built to be able to keep the foam inside more protected and durable and to give it a better bounce back response. Now, inside that, of course, we can't open it up for you guys to see. There's a foam which Under Armour calls, of course, the Hover technology. It's practically or basically like your Under Armour Boost foam, wherein it's built to be able to be more responsive and cushiony. So this is how it feels when it's running, and you guys can validate it when you guys pick one up and you're trying it out in the Under Armour store or when you're working out with it. For me, so when the shoe hits the ground, there's a pop at the toe off here at this particular point of the shoe. It's a mix of the Hover technology, the rubber, and the EVA sole all working together to be able to give you that pop. And as you move upwards or as you lift your feet, the rubber foam really rebounds and gives you that energy response that gives you some sort of springiness. But at the same time, when your feet land, the foam really kicks in, the Hover technology, and allows you a very nice landing on the ground. And that overall experience gives you a really nice stride that just will keep you moving forward. And in that, I think, is what makes the shoe pretty nice. So let's move to the upper. So Under Armour uses some sort of knit technology. It's a little more tighter at the front and on the sides, allowing for your shoe better compression, better containment, and just the overall better support. But if you move upwards and on the side, it's more open. It's more breathable. So the air really comes in from all around your shoe, giving you a much more comfortable stride and more breathable experience with the shoe. Combine the flat knit weave that you have with the upper with the hover technology, and then you have a really comfortable, really nice all-around shoe. And the best part about it is that this is probably among all the trainers that I have, the most affordable one. This one sells for a little over 6,000 pesos, 6,300 or something, which is much more affordable when you compare it, for example, to the Adidas Ultra Boost, which will set you back 9,000, 10,000 pesos, or even the Epic React Flyknit, which goes at 7,600 or 7,700 pesos. So the performance plus the better style, I'm not saying it's like the best style out there, they probably should have still made this smaller, plus of course the overall comfort and the performance really makes this a really wonderful shoe, and I highly recommend that you guys try it out for yourselves, because believe me, you might be missing out if you will just give your feet like the experience of the Boost and the Epic Flyer of the Epic React of Nike. You need to be able to try this as well so that you get a better comparison among the three brands and then get a better feel of which one it is that you really want to use. So that's actually it for this vlog. I just want to do this quick video to be able to talk about the Under Armour Hoversonic while it was still fresh on my mind after a really nice workout at the gym. I hope you guys are having a great week. We have a bunch more videos coming soon, so please make sure that you subscribe. Peace. Have a great week.